Now we're going to talk about how to add letters to numbers that occur in a row. I was asked by a customer. So she had several occurrences of a number in a row, and she'd like to have the A, B, C, D appearing with these numbers. And then when it changes to another number, they would like to have it start all over again at A, B, C, D for each occurrence. So how I'm solving this problem is I'm going to break it down. So let's go in the first cell and let's ask the system, is this number the same as the number ahead of it or on top of it? So let's go an if statement here, and let's go equals if. And so what we're going to do is we'll put the bracket and we'll say, is A2 equal to A1? We'll put a comma. So if that is equal, what we're going to do is just going to leave a blank spot right now. And if it's not equal, then what we're going to do is we're going to take this this value here, and we're going to add the A letter to it. So how this would go is we would go opening bracket, and then we would select this value, and then we'll put the and sign, and then we're going to put quotation marks and an A and the end of quotation marks and end of the brackets, and I think we need another bracket after that. So what happens is you get that. So now when you drag it down, every time there's a new occurrence of a number, you get it with an A beside it. So that's solved part of the first problem. So now let's deal with, so you have the number below it and you want it to be B. Okay, so let's go equals. So this A is a character code. So let's go, so character and then code. And what we're going to do is we're going to take the first number, the first character to the on from the right side of the cell above. So we're going to go right, and we'll select this one for B2, and we want just the one character. And we'll put another bracket, and then we're going to add one to that because we want it to increment by one, right? And then we will count the brackets, and hopefully we're right in closing them. And there you see it's going B, C, D. But that's not kind of what they wanted. They wanted it to be to include the original number with it. So that's pretty easy to change that. So what we're going to do is we'll go in front of the bracket for the character, and we'll put another. We'll put another bracket, and then we'll say this number or this value here, and we're going to put the and sign again, now count our brackets one more time, we'll close that. And there it's working. It's got and it's got the B, D, keeping going. But hey, wait here. We forgot that it has to start over again at A. So now let's put everything together and see if we can get it to work. So we're going to start up here with our if function, which we've already got here. So let's put our formula in here. So what we're going to do is we're going to go opening bracket, and we're going to go A2 and then we're going to go character, and then we're going to go code, and then we're going to go write, and then we're going to go B1, and it's just the first character we want, so let's close that bracket. And then we want to increment it by 1, right? So let's put a plus sign and 1. And then we're going to close these brackets for this little statement here. And let's press enter. So now if we drag this down, we have each of our numbers with a letter beside it, and when it changes to a new number, we now have starting at A again for the new numbers.